Right, obviously we all want our roses to flower all through the season, and really to help them do this, you need to deadhead regularly. So as soon as the petals start to fade and crisp up, you get your lovely kind of sharp, clean secateurs and cut just above the leaf axle. If you keep doing this all season, you can guarantee that your roses will be flowering right up to the end of October, early November. Right, this rose here, look at that, it's a hybrid tea, Belle Epoque. It's a wonderful rose. It has different colours, you know, for the transition of the actual kind of flower. Starts off the bud deep red with a bit of apricot. And then if we move over, as it opens up, you kind of got that bronzy kind of tangerine look to it. And then when it's fully open, we kind of go through shades of pink, light pink, a delicate pink, to the kind of like a rougy pink there. The most important thing you need to know is that roses are very, very hungry. Obviously, during the summer months, we get blooms and blooms and blooms. Those blooms don't come from anything. You have to kind of give them some extra feed. Beginning of the year, they love well-rotted manure or compost, well-rotted in a hole or put a mulch around it, but make sure the compost doesn't touch stem because it can actually kind of burn or scorch it. Most roses will flower all year round, but they have a little kind of, they go to sleep for a little bit after their first flush around August, and then is the best time to give them another feed. You get the granular feed, and you've only got one or two in a few pots, an all-round tomato feed, which is high in potassium, which actually promotes more blooms. Ideally, you should plant your roses, especially in a pot, not in the open, but don't put them up in some dark corner of the garden. Make sure there's plenty of air circulation around them, so any spores that start to attack the rose are technically are blown away. The spores of the black spot does actually likes kind of dank, still air.